Pope Benedict XVI was once interacting with a group of children who had just received the sacrament of Holy Communion. One of the boys, Andrea, asked, "My catechist told me that Christ is present in the Eucharist, but how? I don't see him." The Pope answered him in simple language, "No, we cannot see him. There are many things we do not see, but they exist and are essential. We do not see our intelligence, but we have it. We do not see our soul, and yet we know it exists because we see its effects in our thoughts, actions, and decisions. We do not see electric current, yet we know that it exists because we see lights, we see this microphone working. Similarly, we do not see the very deepest realities of our lives that sustain our lives and the world, but we can see and feel their effects. We do not see love, yet we know it is real when someone hugs us. It is this reality that brings life into the world and keeps the families and the relationships composed. So it is with the Eucharistic Lord. We do not see him with our eyes, but we see the results of his presence. Wherever he is, we see people are transformed and families are united. We see people with a greater capacity for peace and reconciliation. And we experience him when he satisfies the yearning in our souls and in our inner lives. Just as we experience satisfaction for our physical hunger when we eat bread, we may fail to see the presence of our Lord in the bread and wine, but we see the effects of his presence in our lives and in our families when we receive him in faith. So the question is, do we believe that he is truly and really present in the Holy Eucharist? Pope Francis said, "The Eucharist is not a mere symbol, but is in fact the true body and true blood of Christ, which has the ability to transform our hearts and minds to be more like him. We become what we consume and are transformed into a precious gift of God for our brothers and sisters. May the bread of life nourish and tune our hearts into Christ's very own. May our families enter into the dynamism of sacrificial love and become families of peace, forgiveness, reconciliation, and sharing. Amen."